Diane Diamond, welcome to DBL.
Hey, thanks, Lindsay. Thanks for having me.
So I want to start by talking to you about Brittany Murphy. She passed away at age 32, like we all know, supposedly of natural causes.
Hi, my name is Brittany Murphy, and I go to Herbert Hoover Middle School.
So many suspect foul play still. NID Mystery looks at her case from a new perspective. So what do you think is likely the cause of her death?
Tonight, our 9 at 9 special features the Brittany Murphy case. The Los Angeles Medical Examiner determined that she died at just 32 years old, but her estranged father surfaced after her death, and he ordered up a different autopsy. And guess what it found? It found that there were 10 heavy metals in her body. His theory is that Brittany Murphy and her husband, Simon Monjak, who coincidentally died 5 months after she died of exactly the same thing. Brittany's father believes that they were both deliberately poisoned by the third person who lived in that Beverly Hills mansion, his ex-wife, Sharon. You'll also hear from Sharon, and she will vehemently deny that.
I want to talk to you about another case that divided the nation. It was the death of Jeffrey Epstein. So he was arrested for sex trafficking in 2019 and died by apparent suicide in his jail cell, even though he was supposedly guarded at all times. So did Jeffrey die by suicide, or do you think it was all set up?
Well, that's the name of our 3-hour special about him. Who killed Jeffrey Epstein? And you will see that on the night he dies, the cameras in the hallways suddenly didn't work. The two guards on duty that were supposed to look at him every 30 minutes and put it in a log didn't do that. He was already on a suicide watch. You always have to have a roommate, a cellmate in with you to watch you, had suddenly been moved just hours before all this happened. And this is the night that Jeffrey Epstein coincidentally decides to kill himself. It sounds suspicious on its face. And so we walk you through it. We talk about an alternative autopsy that was done on his body. We'll present the facts to you, and you decide what you think.
True crime has become a worldwide phenomenon, as you know, because you've been all over it. Why do you think people are so interested in stories like these?
Everyone is attracted to the unusual. In my case, I'm fascinated by human behavior. I want to know more about what makes my fellow human beings tick, and I don't think I'm alone in that. It's really frightening sometimes, but always, always, it's educational.
And Diane, you're so good at doing just that, giving us education, giving us insight. So we want to thank you so much. I'll be tuning in to all of your projects.
Thank you very much for having me, and I hope everybody there stays safe during this scary time.
Thank you so much.